Hello. Today I'm showing a neat little thing I built. It is a clock that goes up by one every day. Every Minecraft day, the clock goes up, increments by one. This can be useful for things like automatic farm harvesting. So instead of using clocks, like maybe one like this, that of course it would have to be longer, but clocks like this can lag because of the constant updating, and especially on slower computers and servers. But as you can see here, there's nothing moving, there's nothing updating, it's stationary, and then once per day, so once when it becomes night, this turns off, and then when it becomes day again, this turns on. And as you can see, this loop of blocks went over by one. And for every block in this loop, counts as 1 day. So there's 9 blocks currently here. So that means this will take 9 days to complete the cycle. So that means every 9th day, whatever you put here will happen. In this case, I have a little automatic reed farm. So if I just pretend that the days are going by, so each time that this gets powered, it's as if 1 day has passed. And we're 1 day away now from this, so the next day passes, and then as you can see, this was automatically harvested. Now, sugarcane doesn't take 9 Minecraft days to grow, but this can be made smaller just by putting the pistons closer together. Another neat application for this is a calendar of sorts. Here I have a week, sort of a week calendar telling me what day of the week it is. So if you made a new Minecraft world, assuming in Minecraft the days of the week are the same, the world would start on a Sunday, and then you would have to manually keep track of this normally, but you could eventually build one of these that does it for you. So right now this is saying it's Tuesday, but if I pretend that the days are going by again, every time the sun sets, this daylight center turns off, and then when it rises again, it turns on, which causes the cycle to go to all the blocks to go by one. So if I just speed this up, you can see that it now says it's Wednesday. Then it says it's Thursday, and so on. And this works even if people sleep, since it's using daylight sensors. It doesn't skip days or miss days or anything like that. And this keeps going and going. And how this works, and the same thing for over there, is that there's smart pistons. So when a block goes over this torch, it powers this wire, which powers the piston, which causes it to be pushed. And then it goes around in the cycle. And then, of course, there's the one over here. So when this is powered, it causes this piston to go up, which causes a one-tick pulse. So the piston here doesn't stay extended, so it allows a block to be put here. And over here, I only had... And these two actually work slightly differently, because here I have the stationary output that happens once every 9 days. But over here, I want the power source to actually move along the display. So I have it like this. And because of this, because it has to move along this straight display, once it gets to the end here, it's at the end, and I'd have to push it all the way back to the front, the redstone block I'm talking about. It would get down here, and I'd have to push it all the way to the front, and that would be very complicated. So what I did was, I just added more redstone blocks. So once this one reaches the end, like that, after 7 days, this one over here is now in line, and it goes down the line and is the one that lights up the displays, and then this one will be next. And the reason there's three instead of just two is because since there's seven lights, an odd number, there needs to be an odd number of these blocks. This can be, and this might look a little big, but it can be easily compacted by just putting the loop vertically, either on top or below. So if you're building this on the ground, there should be plenty of space to build beneath. And if you do that, this is only two blocks wide, so it's fairly compact. And that's pretty much it. So I thought this was kind of cool. So I hope that you might find a use for it. And you can subscribe for more stuff like this. And thanks for watching.